for an exam and the examination got delayed. So when the postponed exam happened and he still didn't prepare, he did not perform so well. But that's a story for another time. Now to evaluate him, we have amongst us Toastmaster Vamshi. Magic for him is a weekly affair. It happens every Thursday. Right from his childhood, he gets new things every Thursday. For example, if he goes out on a date on Thursday, he will definitely get a second date. If he goes out on Thursday. So, join me in welcoming Toastmaster Vamshi for reading out the speech objectives.
Good afternoon everyone, and Toastmaster Smit in particular. Toastmaster Smit identity is L1P2, and the purpose statements of his project are: purpose of his project is for a member to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback and apply the feedback to a second speech. The purpose of the speech is for a member to present the speech and receive feedback from the evaluator. The time limit to be noted is 5 to 7 minutes. Good luck.
Toastmasters.
Remember the first meeting that you attended in Toastmasters? You can't help to be get people to find the entire structure of it. You see team on, you see tag team, and you see sergeant in arms. You might think you are you're joining something in the army, but that's not the case. One thing that you realize that after attending several meetings, that there are certain types of speakers that you see in Toastmasters. And today, I'm going to walk you through 5 different types of speakers that you meet. Good evening, fellow guests and Toastmasters. So let's begin. The first type, the motivation speaker. Now, this person might not have a stable job. He would hate his job. He might have a turbulent relationship. He might not be able to pay his EMI sometime, and he might not be able to be motivated enough to do any of his work. But when he gets a speaking slot, he would come here and deliver a speech that would motivate all of you. He has a solution for all of your problems. He knows how you can achieve your dreams. Alas, he can't follow his own advice. Otherwise, he wouldn't be the motivational. You will see a lot of such speakers coming here and giving inspirational speeches. That is type number one. Type number two, the storytellers. So one quick thing you will pick up, that a lot of people who come here, they are able to share very interesting stories. They are able to come up with life experiences or childhood memories, and they are able to derive such incredible lessons from such topics. You start to wonder that this is such a mundane thing, that it's uneventful. How are they able to pull out lessons? For example, say you are late for school and you miss the school bus. You just think, I missed the school bus. There's really no big thing about it. You'll say, he'll say, that is a life-changing moment. Early bird catches the worm. And because I snoozed, I lost. So this is how they perceive lessons out of mundane things. See, you didn't do well in the exam. But he will say, failure is the first step for success. I wish I had that skill. When my managers come to me and ask, where is the work? Today's Monday, today's the deadline. I wish I could say, by missing this deadline, I have set up myself for success. But somehow my managers have never believed me. So that's it. The third type is the singers. How many of you ever took part in any of the singing auditions in school or anywhere else? Raise of hands. Mm-hmm. Quite few, but don't worry. Toastmaster is a perfect place to try out your singing skills. See, if you want to sing, most likely if you sing bad, people will kick you off stage. That has happened to me, personally, 3 times in school. But here, you have 27 minutes, and you can inject as many songs as you like. For example, today I'm going to sing the Pokemon theme. Nobody listened to me in school, but you guys have to listen to it. So I'll begin. I wanna be the very best that no one ever was. To catch them is my real test. To train them is my cause. I'll travel across the land, searching far and wide. It's Pokemon, I want to understand the power that's inside. Pokemon. However, if you want to know how to do this well, you can contact Shivika. She has been able to pull this off much better than I have done it. And the fourth step is the dancer. Now, after mentioning singers, how can we leave off the dancers? See, Toastmaster says you should use your hand gestures, you should do movement, your body language. The dancer sees this as an opportunity. He's like, I never got a chance to dance in front of people. Why don't I just try it out here? Here I'll do all sorts of movement, I'll give some speech, but my entire thing is to just dance. So that is also a very good opportunity for you. So that kind of a speaker you'll see here. And finally, the last type of speaker that you encountered here are the stand-up comedians or slash impersonators. They are people like me who didn't prepare content well in advance. And just a day before, they have to come up here and give a speech. So what do? They look at all the speeches that the other Toastmasters have given, find a stereotype in them, and then say it out here. So what is the lesson in all of this? The lesson is that given that people have not kicked me out right now, and members have not got up with pitchforks, everybody is welcome in Toastmasters. You might be a speaker who might have some of these characteristics. You might want to sing actually after coming here, but do it in moderation. Don't sing the entire speech. You are welcome to do that. But one thing you always have to remember, that this is a fun place. You are not being judged. You are here to improve your speaking, yes, but have a lot of fun there, like I am. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Smit, for the fresh perspective about the types of Toastmasters that we see. Now coming to our fourth and final speaker. She has lived in 6 different countries and has gained the distinction of giving her Toastmaster speeches in several cities. Here she will be delivering her speech for the first time. Now her magical moment happened when she found a crazy wish that she had written 2 years ago, and she realized that she had finished most of it. She will be attempting the third project from level 1 of the path, Dynamic Leadership. Before I invite Toastmaster Monica on stage, I would like to call upon her evaluator, Toastmaster Akshay. Now, he's a guest Toastmaster from Morgan Stanley Orators Club. We are really honored to have him here. Now, his magical moment happened when he had a trip, when he went on a trip to Ladakh for a few years ago, and there he made the memories that are magical, and he would like to cherish them for years to come. Join me in welcoming Toastmaster Akshay.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hi.